Hey, what's up? It is Brianna, and today we're going to be sitting down and going over my top 10 favorite eyeshadow palettes, and it's been a hot minute since I've done this video. And since the last one that I did, though, there has been so many palette launches, and honestly, a lot of them have been really good. And also, just in general, I've been trying out so many eyeshadow palettes because they are my guilty pleasure. Like, literally, eyeshadow palettes are my favorite makeup product ever. So anytime I see a new launch or just a really cool color story, I'm always trying it. Since I've tried out a bunch of palettes since my last video, let's just say my last top 10 has gotten a little bit shook up and things have changed a lot. So I just want to share with you guys my favorites because you guys are always asking me which are my favorite palettes and which ones I would recommend, and these are literally like my ride or dies. Like if somebody were to steal my whole makeup collection, these are the first 10 palettes that I would go out and repurchase. So in 10th place for me is the Hot Jalapeno palette from e.l.f. Cosmetics, and oh my gosh, like this palette is just such a steal in general. I believe it's like $3 or $4 and you just get a lot of product in here. And what I really like about it is not only the color story having like this earthy, kind of like edgy, grungy vibe to it, but the formula is just chef's kiss. Because these matte shades right here are intensely pigmented and they're also very easy to work with. Like if you're a beginner, you will not struggle with these at all. And also these shimmers right here are super intense and super sparkly. If you're like me and you like super sparkly shimmers that have a wow factor to them, you will absolutely love this one. To me, the only disadvantage of this palette is I feel like I can't do a lot of different types of looks with it, but honestly for $3 or $4, it's just a literal steal. Now this next palette might surprise some of you guys, and that is the MELT Cosmetics Rust palette. And normally I'm not into warm tone neutrals, like I usually gravitate towards cooler tones. I feel like they just complement my skin a little bit better. But there's something about this palette that just really draws me in, and I just love using it, especially for these darker, more grungy colors down here, because they're just so rich and pigmented, and again, they have like this smoky, edgy kind of vibe to them that I really love. And if you've never tried out MELT Cosmetics before, their formula is just so good. Like again, their mattes are just very, very pigmented to the point you don't even have to build them up if you don't want to. And also their shimmers have a lot of dimension and shine to them. To me, the only disadvantage of this palette though is that it is fairly pricey. I mean, it's $58 for 10 eyeshadows, so it's definitely up there. But again, it is really great quality and I love using mine. ColourPop's Meant to Be has one of the most unique color stories I've ever seen for an eyeshadow palette. Like, it's just so cool and different. And what I really like about it, though, is not only do you get these really cool minty shades right here that fit the mint vibe of the palette, but you also get these really interesting shades. You know, like the seafoam green, this grayish green, which is really unique. I have nothing like it in any of my other eyeshadow palettes. And also this grayish green kind of shade right here. And also this palette has a really nice formula. Like the matte pastels in here are not chalky and they don't like dust away funny. And also the deeper shades in here do not give any harsh lines, which is really nice. And if you're like me and you like really sparkly shimmers, the ones in this palette are just so intense. Let me just show you guys this one right here in the center. Normally I don't do swatches because my hands have really bad eczema, but I just want to show you guys this. I mean, look at how cool that is. Like, I'm just literally obsessed with this palette. Again, to me, the only disadvantage of this palette is that you are kind of limited with the types of looks you can do with it because, again, it is a monochromatic palette. But again, like if you're looking for a really unique, interesting color story or if you're looking for a spring palette, this one right here is so worth checking out. ColourPop's Blue Moon palette has the best blue eyeshadow formula that I have ever used. Like if you're like me and you love blue eyeshadow, you need this one. Like it is so worth getting. Because again, it is so hard to find really nice blues and this palette has absolutely no duds in it at all. To me, the mattes in here are the star of the show. Like the lighter one in here does not act funny or chalky or dusty on the eye. Like it just applies really nice and smooth. The mid-tone, you know, like this true blue right here, this one does not do that weird pressed pigment thing where it looks like chunky and funny, and it also just blends out like butter. And the deeper shades in here, they don't give those like really harsh lines that are hard to correct. Like they actually like blend out seamlessly. Another thing I really appreciate about this palette though is that it just has a really nice tone variety to it. You know, you don't get too many dark shades, you don't get too many light, you just get a good variety of both. And again, the shimmers in here are really great quality and they're super shimmery on the eyes. I especially really like this shade called Lumi because it's just really icy and different. Again, the only drawback of this palette is that it is a monochromatic palette, so you are a little bit limited, but again, like if you're into blues, it's a definite must-have. Now normally I do bright colorful looks, but when I want a neutral glam, I usually tend to use cool tones. And for that, the Stone Cold Fox palette from ColourPop is perfect. Like, it literally has any kind of cool tone neutral you will ever need. I mean, you get these rosy colors over in here, you get the taupes, and you also get true grays as well, which are really hard to find. Because a lot of times gray eyeshadows, they do have like a little bit of like a brown in them, whereas these ones are like 100% gray. And I just feel like you can do a lot of different types of looks with this palette. I mean, you can do like everyday looks, you can do like icier looks, you can do smoky looks. I mean, like the possibilities with this one are literally endless. The disadvantage to me about this palette is that some of the shades in here are very similar to other ones in here, so just keep that in mind. And also, I do feel like this one runs a little bit on the lighter side, like there's more lighter shades and deeper ones. If you're not new to my channel, you know how obsessed I am with my Morphe 39S Such a Gem palette. Like, if you're like me and you love purples, pinks, and burgundies, you will fall in love with this palette. Because, I mean, not only is it like a purple fantasy, but you can just do so many different types of looks with it. Because, I mean, it has like these really beautiful pastels in here. You have these deeper, rich, kind of like purple shades and burgundies. But what's really fun about this palette, though, is that this middle row right here is all top coats. So you can apply them over other shades in here to transform them or use them by themselves. And if you're like me and you do prefer cool tones, this one definitely does have a little bit more of like an icy silvery vibe to it. And again, like this palette to me is one of the most underrated Morphe palettes I have ever used. And I mean, I've tried out a lot of palettes from Morphe, and this one by far has one of the best formulations to it. To me, the only drawback of this palette though is that it is absolutely massive, one of the largest palettes I have in my collection. So I mean, it is a little bit tricky to store. So if you have like a tight space or if you don't like larger palettes in general, you might not like this one because of it. So let's talk about this cute little rainbow moment right here called Fade Into Hue. And again, this one is from ColourPop, and as you can tell, I am ColourPop obsessed. They are one of my favorite brands. But to me, this is one of the most underrated ColourPop palettes by a long shot. I don't know why it doesn't get more love. Because not only does it have a really approachable color story to it for how it's laid out, I mean, you have your pinks, your oranges, and so on and so forth. And also, it goes from light to dark too, so I just feel like it's a really approachable color story for a rainbow palette. So if you are a beginner or if you struggle figuring out your looks, I feel like this one would be amazing for you. But for me right now, I've been really liking this palette because it just screams spring and summer to me because it has a good mix of pastels and brighter shades, and it also has a lot of shine and sparkle in it because it does have some pressed glitters in here. To me, the only disadvantage of this palette though is that some of the shimmers in here, like this pink one right here, aren't like super crazy sparkly, like they're a little bit more of like a wearable shimmer. So in third place, we have the Beauty Bay Bright Matte 42 palette, and right here I have the all matte version. I don't have the one with shimmers mixed in, I only have this one right here, so I can't vouch for how that one is. But let me just say, this is one of those palettes for me that I actually have to hide from myself because otherwise I will not stop using it. Because the formula of the mattes in here is just so blendable and very easy to use. Like, they do not give any harsh lines and they're just really pigmented. And also, this palette is very affordable. I think full price it's around $20, but it's always on sale, which is really nice. Because I think the other day when I was on Beauty Bay's website, they had it on sale for $14, which is a literal steal. But this is just one of those palettes that is kind of like a one and done, because you literally get everything that you need in it, from pastels to neutrals to deeper shades. Like, you can just do so much with this one. So if you're somebody that is looking for a rainbow palette that you can literally do any type of look with, you know, from pastel looks to smoky eyes, I think you would absolutely fall in love with this one. Again, the only disadvantage to me about this palette is that it is 100% matte, so if you're looking for some shimmers, you will have to go in with something else. So the palette that I have in second place might surprise some of you guys, and that is the Be Perfect Stacy Marie Carnival XL Pro palette. And in my previous video that I did doing a top 10, this was actually my number one favorite. But the reason that I'm putting it in number two is because I don't reach for it as much as I used to, and I do slightly prefer number one over this. So, you know, we'll go over number one in a second. But again, I really like this palette, and it's a literal one and done palette. So if you're looking for a palette that has everything that you need in it, you will fall in love with this one. Because again, not only do you get these three face highlighters over in here, but you get a lot of warm tones. You get your cool tones, your blues, your neons. You also get some warm tone neutrals as well as some cool tone neutrals. Again, the reason I haven't been reaching for this palette is because I've been going for like really like bright and fun colorful shades, and also I've been really gravitating towards pinks, reds, oranges, and purples. And this palette, I mean, has those, but it doesn't have the types that I'm looking for. And also, I feel like this palette does lean a little bit more on the neutral side, and because of that, I just go in with my other palette because it's completely bright. And with this palette too, I can't use all of the face highlighters, so I feel like I just don't really reach for it even for that anymore. But when I do use this palette, I do go for like these blues and greens right here, and also this yellow shade, because they're just really fun colors. Especially these greens and blues though. This green shade right here called Nuke, this is a very unique shade. I have nothing like it in any of my other palettes. And also this deeper blue shade, this one is called Mood. Again, a very beautiful formula. Again, I absolutely love this palette, and this is the palette that I travel with, but since I haven't been reaching for it as much, I knocked it down a notch. So my absolute favorite palette right now is the Be Perfect Stacy Marie Carnival Volume 3 Love Tahiti, and oh my gosh, like I cannot get enough of this one. I have it on right now and only this, and it's just such a stunning, well-formulated palette. You can just literally do so much with it too. Again, I wouldn't consider this a one and done palette, but if you're like me and you like bright colorful shades and you like duochrome shimmers, you will fall in love with this one. And also, I just feel like it has a really fun colorful vibe, especially going into summer. But what I like about this palette though is the formula. Like, hands down, it has one of the best formulas I have ever used. Like, the mattes in here are pigmented to the point you don't even have to build them up if you don't want to, whether that is a lighter color, a mid-tone, a bright, or even a deeper one. Like, literally one layer and you're good to go. And also, the shimmers in here are absolutely beautiful. I mean, like, this shade right here that I have on my lid right now, this one is called Starlight, and it's like this duochrome fantasy. I mean, look at how absolutely stunning that is. I just feel like you can do so much with this palette, and if you're like me and you love pinks and purples, like, it just has so many beautiful ones in here. And this blackberry shade right here though is one of my favorite shades in this palette because it's just like a beautiful rich purple that just has a really nice pigmented formula that's so easy to blend out. I do wish that this palette had some yellows in it or some more blues, but I mean, again, like, I just can never put this one down. And what I really like about the color story though too is that it has these really cool kind of like grungy greens over in here. They're just really unique shades that I would have not expected in this palette, but they're really fun and they're just really different. And all the shimmers in this palette have a lot of dimension to them. Like, there is absolutely no duds in here at all. Like, it's just an absolutely stunning formula. And again, they are very pigmented and really creamy too. But yeah, so those are my top 10 favorite eyeshadow palettes. And let me tell you, it was so hard to do this because, again, I love eyeshadow palettes. They're my favorite makeup product. So it was really hard to, like, pick 10 and only 10. But you know what? I feel like these are, like, the creme de la creme. But in the comments down below, let me know what you think about the palettes that I picked, and also let me know what your top 10 is as well. But as always though, if you haven't already, make sure you hit the subscribe button down below and also give this video a like. And if you'd like to check me out over on Instagram or TikTok, it is @BriannaFaye as well. And I'll talk to you guys later. Bye!